Well, hello there.
Welcome back to another Artsy BV video. I'm B, and today I'm going to show you what I got from Amazon. One of the first things that I bought was a bunch of washi tape. I've been into it recently. I've watched a lot of stationery videos and a lot of anime art journals, and so I got a bunch of it. So I got a lot of these patterned washi tapes, and then I also got a bunch of just normal rainbow washi tape because I thought that this would be perfect to kind of accent any of these. I think I went a little overboard on the washi tape, but it's just all so cute, I couldn't help myself. I also got a new pencil case. My old one, it looks very worn out, and it also doesn't fit everything in it that nice. These pencils don't fit in there, I'd have to sharpen them down to get them to fit. And then I have so many pens that I need to go through, but let's get everything switched over. Yay, they fit. That's so exciting. Out with the old and with the new. The next thing I got was a new notebook. I am obsessed with buying notebooks and journals, writing pads, and then using them maybe once or not even at all, and not doing anything with them. This one's really cool because it's not actually bound by right here, so it opens up and it sits flat. The pages aren't super thick, but I'm planning on using this more for pencils and not really markers or watercolors or anything like that. But this is gonna be my new sketchbook for sketching, and I also wanna do a video series called Improving My Art, where I will kind of watch a couple YouTube videos on specific things like poses or eyes or clothes, you know, wrinkles, stuff like that, and then kind of draw it in here and show you my process of trying to improve my art. I bought some really cool pens from Amazon that I've been wanting for a while, and apparently it came with some sticky notes. So these are the Tombow Furunosuke pens. I don't know if I'm pronouncing those correctly, but I'm really excited for these pens. Okay, so this one was pretty soft, and this one is a lot harder. They look the same, but I can tell the difference when I'm pressed down on them. And this one actually has dual-sided. Oh, whoa. Oh, okay, and then this side is gray. That's pretty cool. I can see it on the back, but it's not bleeding through. I think if you were to actually sit there and draw on it for a while, it would bleed through, but that's pretty good. So one of the last things I got was this marker storage. So it's a bunch of individual trays that you can stack together. Let's see how this works. I really wanted to get this for my Copic markers. Right now I have them just in their case that they come with, and it goes like this, and it's nice for storing them upright, but I want to start storing them sideways, and if you try to do that, they kind of slide out a little bit. Let's put away my markers. And perfect, there is all my markers. So I like to organize my markers by red, orange, yellow, green, blue, purple, and then the browns and the grays. And then I also like to do it darkest to lightest for each color, but then also store it kind of like, if you can see the blues right here, these are kind of like the teals, and then the navy blues, and then these are more of like purpley blues. So I kind of like to group them together by that too. And the last thing that I got that I'm super excited about is, well, these Ohuhu. Brush markers. So on one side is the broad tip, and then on the other side is the brush, which I don't own any Ohuhus with the brush tip. It also comes with this, and I've heard a lot of people say on videos they don't get what the point of this is, or they think it doesn't work that well. I've actually used it quite a bit with my Ohuhu markers. If I'm drawing and I don't want it to go on the second page, you can just put it in there. And then you can draw and the color won't transfer from this page and bleed through to this page. So I really like that they put that in there. I think that that's a nice little addition. Oh, and then they also added a little sheet where you can swatch in all your colors. Let's do that right now. So there is all the colors, and then also a colorless blender. Also, fun fact, potato brown is one of Drawing with Waffles' favorite color. So now that you've seen everything that I got, I thought it would be really fun to make a little art piece from some of the stuff. So I was thinking about making a little video series called Improving My Art. And I would kind of focus on, you know, like how to draw poses, how to draw hair, you know, kind of break everything down that I want to improve on and break it down into little chunks and just film a little video for each one and just show you kind of my process of how I am learning to do new stuff and kind of just work on one thing at a time instead of trying to, you know, work on drawing eyes and faces and the body pose and everything like that. I think that it would be really fun to just kind of break it down and do one thing at a time. First thing that I wanted to work on was drawing poses. So I'm using a website called quickposes.com, and I'm just going to be quickly drawing a couple body poses, and I think I'm going to do the 5-minute time limit just so that I can kind of work on getting a little bit more in depth. And then what I thought would be really fun would be to, since all of the, I can't show you the website because everybody is naked in all the pictures, and I didn't really want to draw a bunch of naked people, but I thought it would be really fun to draw the body poses and then use washi tape and make little washi tape bikinis for everyone. So that is what I'm going to do. I really love how this sketchbook spread turned out. I love how I did the different poses. The one girl is turned away from us. Some are sitting, some are standing. I think that they all turned out really good. The one on the bottom left corner, the very last one that I do, that one wasn't my favorite just because it was such a hard pose for me to draw. So it took me a little bit longer than the other ones, but I absolutely love all the poses. The two girls in the middle or towards the middle, I think are my absolute favorite. I'm really happy with how they turned out. I just think that they turned out super good, and that already makes me feel like I'm improving just a little bit with my poses. So I'm really excited about that. Never had washi tape before, so it was a little bit different than I thought. I don't know if it was just the washi tape that I bought, but it was really sticky. I thought that washi tape was supposed to be kind of easy, where you put it down and, you know, you can pull it up if you need to. But once I put it down, if I wanted to pull it up in some spots, it would kind of rip the paper a little bit, so I had to be kind of careful with that. Also, whenever I watch Casey Golden work with washi tape, she's always so good with lining up the washi tape and all the patterns align and it looks really good. I tried to do that, but I couldn't even find where the patterns lined up, so I don't know. I did my best. Working with the washi tape was pretty tedious. I haven't ever really, you know, worked with the X-Acto knife and cut little pieces out, and so it was a new experience. It was really fun to make the washi tape into bikinis. I would love to know what you use washi tape for. So let me know in the comments what you use it for, if you use it for studying or for stationery, or, you know, what you do with your washi tape.
think that my favorite swimsuit is the girl in the black thong. I thought that one was pretty funny and cute. At the last minute, I decided to show some cheekies. So, yeah, that one's my favorite. I know that I already said that I liked how everything turned out, but I'm re-watching this. I'm realizing how much I love how everything turned out. I feel like my last couple drawings, even before my YouTube videos, have just like, I don't know, something happens where it's either like I don't like the pose, or I don't like how the marker ended up looking, or the line art turned out really scratchy, or there's always been something that I'm kind of just like eh about. But I think all of these turned out really good. I loved how my line art turned out. I loved that I highlighted the two girls in the middle just by coloring them. And I think I really love how everything turned out in this. In my other videos, I've said like, oh, you know, I really like this, but I want to work on this. And for this video, I am super excited and proud of it. And so I don't have anything that I want to work on based off of this video. Hope you guys had as much fun watching the video as I did making it. It would mean the absolute world to me if you could like or subscribe, and thank you so much for watching.